If you're looking to display your vehicle's remaining fuel information on your GPS tracking console, along with positioning data on your web portal, then this video is for you. In this video, I demonstrate using a Teltonika-based GPS tracker. This video is part 2 of my previous video, connecting Teltonika GPS tracker to vehicle fuel gauge sensor, which focused on the hardware interface for acquiring remaining fuel information. This video, however, concentrates on the application side or configuring tracking platform to interpret and present acquired fuel information on the portal with free GPS tracking platforms like Traccar, Ruhavik, and Flespi. However, the concepts discussed can be applied to any platform. Now, here is the summary. GPS tracker get data from vehicle and pushes to Flespi. Then Flespi, after processing, push that data to Ruhavik to display on user screen. Since the Teltonika FMB122 supports Bluetooth, the first approach I'll cover is interfacing it with a Bluetooth OBD2 scanner as shown here. Connect tracking device to computer or laptop using a USB cable for configuration and status checks and diagnostics, and then open the configuration software to access and review the device's setting. The status tab used for diagnostic topper shows device master information, while below tabs displays real-time information like GNSS data, GSM details, input-output parameters, and OBD2 scanner. Monitor live data such as GPRS status, satellite count, ignition status, battery voltage, engine temperature, and RPM, all organized into 4 tabs within the status section, as you can see here. Focus on analog input 2, which is connected to the vehicle's fuel sensor and will be used to display remaining fuel data. 500 millivolts of analog input 2 means fuel tank is full, while 7,500 millivolts means fuel tank is empty. Currently, it is 4,383 millivolts that corresponds to remaining fuel of 54% approximately. Access the OBD tab to view information like engine RPM, coolant temperature, etc., but the remaining fuel data not visible. Navigate to the Bluetooth tab and configure the OBD2 connection with Traccar. Configure this general area if you want to connect your mobile device via Bluetooth with the GPS tracker for configurations and diagnostics or status update. In the Auto Connect to External Device section, select OBDII and initiate discovery and pairing process for your OBD2 scanner. Enter the scanner's MAC address, name, and PIN in the designated fields. Already paired devices are also shown here, as you can see. After completing these steps, apply the configurations to establish a successful connection with the OBD2 scanner. Next, move to the I/O tab shown to view and configure different input-output parameters in detail. I will not discuss this in much details as being out of scope and lengthy, but you can ask in comments. Next, move to the OBD2 tab. As you can see, current value for most engine parameters is blank, including the remaining fuel level. Only green colored parameters are supports by this Corolla 2007. If your vehicle provides fuel level information via OBD2, then better use it or otherwise connect the analog input 2 with the fuel gauge as discussed earlier and follow the steps onwards. Create accounts on both Flespi and Ruhavik. Log in to Flespi and go to the Telematics Hub node to start adding your device. Add a new GPS tracking device via the device node. Click Add, enter the device name, and choose its type, Teltonika FMB122 or Sinotrack. Enter device's unique ID or IMEI and save the device to complete the setup. Create a channel for the device according to its data protocol. Flespi will usually auto-detect protocol or enter otherwise. Save the protocol. Copy the host and port info and configure it on your device using USB or SMS. This tells device where to send the data from the internet. Define the fuel level plugin by going to the plugins node and adding a new plugin. Name the plugin and remove any sample configuration. Paste the fuel underscore level calculation PVM code into the configuration as detailed earlier. If you are interested to know how this code has been written, please see the documentation, or if you need to modify this code, ask ChatGPT as well. Save the plugin and assign it to your device. and assign it to your device. Next, create a stream to push all message received from the tracker to the Ruhavik portal. Go to the Steam node, create a stream, assign it a name, select Ruhavik protocol, assign your vehicle to it. Assign your vehicle to it. Now switch to Ruhavik. Create a new device. Select Flespi Gateway as the device type. And enter the device's unique identifier or IMEI. Save. Now Flespi will push message to Ruhavik with this unique identifier along with calculated remaining fuel information defined via plugin there. As you can see in the mobile phone screenshot. On Traccar, same feature is available with the name of computed attribute, but the problems is on the demo version of website, this feature is not available as being login with normal user privileges. If you have an on-site installation or admin privileges, then you can use this feature. Go to the admin menu, then select the computed attributes, create a new computed attribute. On this screen, you can define your custom computed attribute. So create the one to calculate remaining from voltage level given by analog input 2. Here, analog input 2 is represented by IO6, unlike Flespi, where it was AIN.2. Wyatt will define later, also in Traccar calculated, written in JEXL format. If you want to learn more or modify the formula, see the documentation, but for now simply add a new computed attribute and copy, paste the calculation formula and save. Next, assign this computed attribute to your vehicle or pool of vehicle. Now you can see computed value of remaining fuel as well as IO6 or analog input 2 as shown here. Now here is the summary. GPS tracker get data from vehicle and pushes to Flespi. Then Flespi after processing push that data to Ruhavik to display on user screen. Steps were created an account, create a device, define a channel and calculation plugin, create a Steam for Ruhavik and connect both. For further details, click the link. The car fuel tank has a float connected to a variable resistor. Changing resistance or voltage based on the fuel level is indicated by the gauge in the car. This video simulates the fuel gauge sending unit using a potentiometer. All wiring connections are made via this breadboard, following the wiring diagram shown here. Both the multimeter and potentiometer are connected to analog input 2 of the Teltonika GPS tracker. The multimeter shows changing voltage levels as we rotate the potentiometer, altering the resistance. The variable resistor in car fuel tanks functions similarly, adjusting to changing fuel levels. 7.5 volts indicates empty fuel tank, while 0.5 volts indicates full tank. These ranges may be changed in some vehicles, so observe analog input 2 and adjust the calculation formula accordingly if need. Currently, we have 7.5 volts, meaning the fuel tank is empty. Let's rotate the potentiometer to decrease the volts, simulating an increasing fuel levels. Also observe the changing analog input 2 or fuel readings in the configuration software, as well as the portal. Now at 0.5 volts, the fuel tank becomes full. Rotate the potentiometer counterclockwise to simulate decreasing fuel levels. Also observe the changing analog input 2 or fuel readings in the configuration software, as well as the portal. Calculating remaining fuel information from analog input 2 values formula has been derived from the point slope form, that is derived system of linear equations as shown. If voltage ranges for a full and empty tank are different in your vehicle, you can ask ChatGPT to return a modified mathematical formulas for both Traccar or Flespi as I did. Teltonika uses AVL ID as a unique identifier to distinguish between different data packets. This allows the receiving server to correctly interpret and process the data received accordingly. Servers extracts the GPS coordinates, speed, fuel levels, and other telemetry data from packets using the AVL ID assigned to each. See the documentation for the details. You can use serial Bluetooth terminal on Android or Win terminal on Windows to debug Teltonika trackers. This provides real-time access to the device's logs to monitor packets, troubleshoot, and diagnose. Connect to COM port where Teltonika tracker is attached. Send command to display logs. Keenly analyze the logs. See the contents of packets sent in the log file versus relevant AVL IDs of device on the website. Similarly, you find other data parameters sent by your tracker and configure your application accordingly for better user understanding and functionality. Hope now you can better understand how to configure your tracking device as well as the portal display fuel level information as well as others information. Thanks for watching.